ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930 present The Drive.
It is Friday, July 14th. Your weekend begins now right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. We're going to have fun this hour. We're going to open up the fax line, text line, whatever we call it. Pigeon carrier. The ways you can communicate with the program, we're going to open those up. The text line, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. On Twitter, you can find me at Paul Swann. And, of course, you can always, always, always email me, paulswann@espn941.com. So we've got several ways for you to get a hold of me today. Stand back. We're going to maybe get into a fight today. We've got a lot to get into, but we're going to get into a fight today. There was a tweet earlier today on Twitter because, after all, there's so many accounts that cover college football, cover college sports, and one of those accounts today put out one of those lists. You know the list I'm talking about, always wanting to start a fight. Here's the best thing at Marshall or WVU or Kentucky. It's listing all the colleges. Best thing in this college town. Best linebacker at each school. Best whatever the thing is. So today might get a little personal because we've got, and it's already taken off on Twitter, so we're going to go with it right now. We're going to get into it. Best pizza in Huntington, or if you just want to consider the tri-state, the region, because it's in relation to Marshall, best college town. Marshall, of course. Huntington is a college town in so many ways. The best pizza is Monty's. Is that the choice? Is that the go-to choice for pizza on a game day? Or is that the choice? So I know I'm going to tick some people off. We've got difference of agreement already going on, and we'll do that here. Text lines 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Now, of course, I thought we solved this debate earlier this year. We had across all our radio stations, we had an event. It was Kindred Munch Madness, and our pizza division winner was it was Star County Market and Pizza. Is it Star County? It's Star Country. Star Country Market and Pizza. The pepperoni pizza at Star Country Market and Pizza was determined by listeners across all our radio stations as the best pizza. So it's on the list already. It's a combatant today just because it gets a bye for being in our Munch Madness promotion earlier this year. But I want to hear from you. If you're going to tell someone who comes in to Huntington for a ball game, like, look, here's what you need to know for game day. You want to get a pizza. The best pizza? Is it Monty's? Or is there someone else that makes a better pizza? Is there someplace else that makes a better pizza? And you can text those responses in 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. We'll get into that here with you throughout the day. We've also got another debate. I didn't know if I wanted to get into this one because, honestly, I don't think it's really going to be much of a debate, especially, hey, I got to know my audience. NCAA posted a story, and I was like, okay, this is interesting. We'll look at this. Trey Lance versus Randy Moss. Who was the better one-year FCS wonder? So Lance led North Dakota State to a 16-0 record in 2019. Of course, Moss, part of the 15-0 Marshall team that won the national championship in 1996. Which one is the better one-year FCS wonder? Now, I don't think Trey Lance is going to get a fair shake, not with this audience. But if you want to step up, you want to carry Trey Lance's water today, I'll entertain it. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Is this even a debate? Can we just giggle at it? Can we laugh at it? I mean, no disrespect, Trey Lance was a pretty good football player a few years ago. Pretty good. That was a really great season for them. North Dakota State, great football program. Nothing taken away from, but Randy Moss was transformative there. I'm stealing a word. I'm stealing language from Christian Spears, Marshall's athletic director. Randy Moss was transformative. No way. There's no way Marshall bulldozes its way into 1A football without the significant contributions of Randy Moss. And just the fact that you're leaving Division 1 AA, you're leaving it, final season, and you're getting to play a team that beat you the previous year. You want to get your revenge. You want to leave on top. You want to leave kings of the division. And nobody really came close to you. Okay, maybe Appalachian State, but nobody came close to you that season. And so Randy Moss running shotgun over everybody, and there was a pretty good quarterback there as well. Remind me his name, Pennington, I think it was. So is this even a fair comparison? Can we have this comparison? Can we have this debate? I don't know if we can. It won't be fair, not with this audience, and that's why I'm throwing it out there. Are you willing to make the argument for Trey Lance? Can you make the argument for Trey Lance? And I know that's a question that probably is not going to get a fair shake, because I don't think anyone wants to take that. If you want to take a shot at that, text line 304-396-8255. Again, text line 304-396-8255. That's the number to be a part of today's edition of The Drive. All right, we're gonna take some of your suggestions. If somebody's coming into Huntington, somebody's coming to game day, they want to know where all the good places are, where are you telling them the best pizza is? Is it, according to Twitter, according to Big Game Boomer, I can't believe I'm doing this, but is it Monty's Pizza, according to Big Game Boomer on Twitter, or is there another? More coming up on this edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
It's a Friday edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. And by rule, I set the rules. We have fun on Fridays. Twitter caught my attention earlier. And again, everybody's got a list. Everybody's got an opinion. Everybody's going to put their list out there. And so I saw this one earlier from Big Game Boomer. Best pizza in every college town. So, okay, what's the representative for Marshall? And it was Monty's. And I thought, okay, that's a strong answer. Monty's is a strong answer. When you think of pizza, a lot of people will say Monty's is your best-known pizza. So, okay, you put that on the list, right? But is that the real choice? I don't know. I don't know what the best choice is. So we put it out there to you. And I did ask that question on Twitter. And you can find me there at Paul Swann. Of course, I'm opening up the text line as well for you at 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. So here we go. Let's find out what you have to say as far as your go-to pizza. If you're telling somebody, hey, on a college game day, you're looking for some pizza, this is where you need to go, what did you say? I'll go with the replies first to the actual tweet, then I'll go with some of the quotes. Backyard got mentioned, Backyard Pizza and Raw Bar. Okay, so it's on the list. What else got mentioned? Someone said that Everoni's. They said, I'm going Everoni's. Of course, it's not Huntington, but it is best pizza by far. And I'm going to accept that because, again, I think the tri-state doesn't have to necessarily be just Huntington for this exercise because there are a lot of people in Canova, Cerrito, Proctorville, Barbersville, Milton, the area. You know, it's all Marshall country, right? It's herd country. So I'll go with that. I'll take Everoni's. Where else did I get a suggestion? Kaylin Layburn's parody account messaged me and said that they're driving to Proctorville and they're getting Romeo's. It's the best pizza they've ever had. So Romeo's is on the list. You know, I don't think I've actually had Romeo's pizza. We need to rectify some of this. I need to go on a tri-state tour. So if we can get some pizza places to invite us, we'll go on tour. We'll do the pizza tour of the tri-state. So Romeo's is on the list here. Also, Giovanni's getting some representation. Twitter said, going to Giovanni's. Giovanni's in Colgrove and Ironton are better, but I'm headed to Giovanni's. And I'm not going to lie to you. I have recently gotten pizza at Giovanni's. And I've gone back several times. I even got sandwiches at Giovanni's. So Giovanni's is on my short list as well. I'm not going to lie to you. Monty's and Giovanni's have been recent places I've gotten pizza. But this isn't about me. It's about you. So you're picking. And then just a couple of responses to, is Monty's your go-to choice for pizza? A couple of people said no, but I kind of be curious what their choice would be. So that's some of the responses we have got. I got another response for Everoni. So Everoni's getting a little love here on the program. Bellasino's got a little love. So, okay, Bellasino's is on the list now. Here's one that I didn't think of, and maybe I should. Ty on Twitter said that Al's New York Pizza, that's in the Big Lots Plaza, you know, Route 60. That's the pizza. That's where you go and get pizza. So we've got an interesting breakdown so far of where your pizza choices are. You can add to this. Did something get listed that you agree with, or is there some place that we're missing? Text lines 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Okay, I am going to disqualify a few things. First of all, places like, now, when I say a chain, I mean a national chain. We're not accepting national chain. If you tell me the best place to get a pizza, and I want local responses. I don't want to hear, oh, hey, go to Domino's. Hey, go to Pizza Hut. Hey, go to Little Caesars. All fine options. All fine options. But for the sake of argument here, I want to know which pizza chain represents Marshall best. Which pizza chain? If you're telling somebody coming in, hey, when you're in Huntington, you're coming to Huntington for the game. When you're in Huntington, you got to go here. And the internet, before this debate began, said that Monty's is your go-to choice for pizza. So if you agree with that or you disagree with that, the text line is 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. So we'll go further into this and see how far you're willing to take it. I think we've got some good choices here so far. And again, I need to go on a tour while we have time. I need to go on a tour of pizza places across the immediate area. I don't know if I want to be the one determining. I don't think that would be fair, but we've got some good choices here so far. So definitely, personally, I might give a nod to Giovanni's, personally. But that's without going and refreshing myself on all of these. So I definitely would say that right now a go-to pizza for me is Giovanni's. Texter just said, was Husson's on 4th before a car ran through it? Well, there was that pizza place right across from Old Main. Then a car went through it. I believe that was Husson's. So, but is that the pizza you're going to tell people? That are you going to lament that one and go, yeah, you know, back in the day before a car went through it, Husson's was the pizza to go to for Marshall fans. You come to Huntington on a game day, it was Husson's. And then a car took it out. And we've been, ever since, we've had a black cloud over us. Because we don't have a choice. No, I don't know. I might disqualify that one. Personally, I might disqualify that one. I'll let you guys decide. But, Simon Cowell would say, it's a no for me on that one. All right, Texter says, best pizza, La Familia. Okay. Strong representative. I can put that on the list. And, of course, this is our unofficial list. I like that one. The only one I'm going to veto is Husson's. Just me, I think you have to have sort of that. It's got to feel like I can't get this anywhere else. This pizza, I can't get this anywhere else. I don't want something that, you know, it gets replicated. I don't want that. I want, where can I get something that I can't get this anywhere else? And that's what I'm looking for here. I think we've got some really good choices so far. Because where else can you get a Monty's pizza? And that's the one that was selected on Twitter, a part of the list we're debating here. I can't get a Monty's pizza anywhere else. I could go anywhere across the country. I'm never going to find a Monty's pizza. And I don't think I'm going to find an Everoni's pizza anywhere else across the tri-state. You got to go to Everoni's. And you can't find Everoni's elsewhere. Giovanni's, pretty much the same. Now, of course, Giovanni's a little bit more widespread, but I still feel like that counts. You couldn't go to Montana and get a Giovanni's pizza. You couldn't do that. So I want, what stands out? What's the best pizza? What is the one that if you've got people coming out of town that come watch the Marshall game and they're coming in, they want a pizza the night before or they want a pizza after the game, where are you taking them? 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. That's our number to be a part of today's edition of The Drive here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. We got some other things to get into as well, but we'll keep this one going. And again, you can also find me on Twitter, always on Twitter, at Paul Swann. So if you've got some suggestions there, guess what? We'll be reading them as well. More coming up on this edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Our text line is open, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. We're looking for that go-to pizza choice on game day. Twitter started this. I'm going to finish it. Game boomer. Big game boomer on Twitter. According to one of that account's list, said that the best pizza in Marshall, best college town pizza from Marshall, Monty's. What says you? Twitter, at Paul Swann, text line 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Text line says, Gino's Pub. There's a place I haven't heard in a while come up. So Gino's was the place to go for a long time. Always a fun destination. The pub, of course. Yeah, there's so much history there with the pub. As a kid, it was great to go to the pub. It really was. And they had the game room. They had all the big screens. I mean, this was just, hey, you want to go to the pub? Yeah, as a kid, always wanted to go to the pub. So it's on the list, definitely. And, of course, they've got the old Marshall scoreboard out there. I haven't been to the pub in a long time, but it used to be the place to go. You wanted to watch a big wrestling pay-per-view. You wanted to go see the coach's show. You wanted to go there. It was definitely on the list. And I'll say this for Gino, some really good sandwiches there as well. Can never say anything bad about the pub. I can't do it. Texter says, glad that Gino's Pub got a mention. Coaches shows and wrestling pay-per-view nights were so much fun there when I was in college. Yeah, that's the thing. I think we need to go with the atmosphere as well. For some of these places, you're not going to be able to go in. You can't go in and just eat, say, at Monty's anymore. Monty's was the choice for Twitter on the account that I was following today, Big Game Boomer with that list. And again, I don't think we're knocking any of these choices here. I think we're just trying to figure out where do we like to go for our, if we're going to tell somebody where to go for pizza and you're saying, hey, Marshall is all about this, this, and this pizza. And for many years, it was the pub. Pub was super cool. Pub's still super cool, but it was definitely the go-to for a lot of years after games. Texture says, after a herd victory, make the drive to Canova and eat at Everoni's. Okay, Everoni's is getting some love there. You know my problem with Everoni's? Every time I want an Everoni's pizza, there's a line. Come on. Pick a day where I can go get an Everoni's pizza. Seriously, I have never driven past Everoni's and not seen a line. I'm going to have to find out what's the one time that nobody's getting pizza and go get an Everoni's pizza. Absolutely. So shout out to Everoni's. Shout out to everyone who goes there. And there have been a lot of people prior to this conversation that would absolutely fight me if you said something bad about Everoni's, because that's their go-to. Text line continues, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. That's our number to be a part of today's edition of The Drive right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. But, you know, going back to the pub, I mean, seriously, I think the pub would win over most just because of the memories there. And again, we're keeping this focused on not necessarily, hey, just go in and get it. But if you're looking for some place that represents what it is to be, you know, if you're going to say, hey, this is the pizza of Marshall fans, this is the pizza, I think we might not be able to narrow it down to one, but we've got some pretty good choices on the list so far. All right, on Twitter, Greg from Twitter says, backyard or Everoni's? Monty's ain't bad, but don't think I'd put it the top of the list. Okay, that's fair. And again, I'm not going to lie to you. I had a Monty's pizza the other day. I wanted Monty's. I got Monty's. And a few weeks ago, I wanted sandwiches from Giovanni's. And sometimes I want pizza from Giovanni's. So, and I'll tell you right now, I like going to Giovanni's by Marshall. It's a great location. It's a great place to get a pizza. And it's going to be on my short list. Giovanni's is going to be on my short list. Absolutely. If I was going to order a pizza tonight, Giovanni's is on my short list right now. But I think my list has grown thanks to this show today. Absolutely. So, Backyard or Everoni is getting some love. And if you were going to, maybe I need to pin you down on this a little bit. If you're going to pick one or the other, would you take Backyard or Everoni's? Can you decide? Is it like which finger you want to, you know, I mean, if you had to lose a finger, which one would you take? If you had to lose a pizza place, you could only have one. Would it be Backyard or would it be Everoni's? I don't want to be in that position. So I'm going to tread lightly here. I don't want to have to decide. Ultimately, I can only have one for the rest of my life. Which one would it be? 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255, our text line to be a part of today's show. Earlier in the sports world day, a lot of UK fans were happy last night after it was all over because Kentucky beat Canada 93-69, the Global Jam Basketball Tournament. So it was a double-digit victory. The Wildcats will play Africa tomorrow, 1:30. That'll be on our sister station, Cat Sports, 93.3 and 1340. And then in the Global Jam title game Sunday night at 8 o'clock. And also, that'll be over on our sister station, Cat Sports, 93.3 and 1340. Baseball returns tonight. We've got the game for you, the Pirates, playing host the Giants, 7:05 tonight, right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Reds opening up a series against the Brewers. We'll see which one of these teams can get on top. This will really determine a few things. If the Brewers take the series, the Brewers are going to have the lead. If the Reds can take the series, the Reds should be fine. So big series here. Cleveland opening up a series at Texas, and that's going to be at 8:05 tonight. And then last night, Gastonia at Charleston. That game was rained out. The Dirty Birds playing host to the Southern Maryland Blue Claws tonight, 6:35. That's going to be up at Gomart Ballpark. And if you've been following along the Summer League, that's coming up tonight, 10:30. Tavion Kinsey and the Utah Jazz take on the Phoenix Suns in Las Vegas. I hope Tavion gets a little bit more action at the rim tonight. I want to see Tavion. Maybe we'll see him more of an offensive threat than someone who's been a facilitator. And I'm not criticizing his game. I want to see more Tavion making plays. I don't want to see Tavion facilitating. I don't want to see Tavion out there in the support role. I want to see Tavion maybe get a little bit aggressive. I mean, don't go chucking things up just to make it happen. I seriously want to see him get some good shots off. And I hope we see that. And that's coming up tonight, 10:30, if you're staying up late. Tavion and the Utah Jazz taking on the Phoenix Suns. That's going to be in Las Vegas. And how many of you took advantage of the ticket plans that went on sale this morning? The mini plans? The plans involve three games. If you take the plan with Virginia Tech and Arkansas State, you get to pick that package with one other game. And then the other mini plan, you get to pick three of five games. That excludes the Virginia Tech game. I don't know how many of you have taken advantage of that. If you're waiting for single game tickets, those are going to become available for purchase. Big Green members will get a shot at those first on July 28th and then general public on August 3rd. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Which pizza represents your choice? If you were going to say the best pizza for Marshall fans, the best pizza, what's it going to be? Text line 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. More coming up on this edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Welcome back to the Friday, July 14th edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. I'm your host, Paul Swann. Our text line this hour is 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Marshall on Twitter today making it official. New assistant coach named for the Marshall men's basketball team, and it's Justin Caldwell. That's official today. Caldwell served as head coach at Glenville State the past five seasons. He's going to be working with Neil Skaggs to build a lot of community relations, Release says, and to help get the kids involved in the tri-state, state of West Virginia. He's got a lot of that experience as far as helping in the community, things like that. So that's what the Release says today. During his time at Glenville State, Caldwell mentored John Williams, who was an NCAA Division II All-American and a two-time All-MEC performer. He also coached former Marshall player Phil Bledsoe, who was a two-time All-MEC first-team selection. Also, bet you didn't know this. I didn't know this. Caldwell was an elite scorer in his college days, according to the Release. He tallied 1,997 points in 3 years at West Virginia Wesleyan and one season at Glenville State. During his year with the Pioneers, he averaged 23.7 points per game. And, oh, by the way, he seems to know Kim Stevens. I think they know each other from Glenville State. So I think. Let me double check that. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. I love the Twitter interactions already. Kim Stevens Caldwell tweeted out earlier, retweeting the men's basketball tweet that it made it official, the welcome tweet, and Coach Stevens Caldwell said, "Bet you're going to miss sharing an office with me." So, a lot of family motifs coming along here with her football and basketball as of late here. So, should be fun basketball season. Definitely for the women, definitely for the men. We should have a couple of entertaining teams, I hope at least. Text line again, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. That's our number to be a part of the program right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. So while we've been debating the all-important question of who is the, you know what, better way to say that is, if you're going to tell people that are not from the tri-state, that are coming into Huntington, coming into the area for the first time, to go see a Marshall game, and they want to know, hey, where's the best this? And today it's pizza. Where's the best pizza? We want pizza after the game. We want pizza before the game. Where do we go? Where do we get the very best? And according to one of the college football accounts that I keep an eye on, Big Game Boomer, it's Monty's Pizza. Some of you have had some differences of opinion. Everybody's been polite about it. I don't think anyone disputes that Monty's is good. I think it's just everyone's got their favorite. And there have been some differences of opinion. We go back to the text line. Texter says, "I was a fan of Husson's Pizza, but someone had to crash into their building. And I don't think they're even there anymore." No, they're not there anymore. I know it's been a while, probably since you've been down there. And so they're not there anymore. There's going to be a little bit of a remodel in that area of Huntington. So I don't know if you knew that. Texter also, this is in response to, I believe, Monty's. "The grease is hard to replicate." Hey, man, that's a selling point for me. It's a tasty pizza. I am not against ever getting a Monty's pizza. Never would I turn down a Monty's pizza. You say, hey, we're having Monty's pizza tonight. Here I am. I'm in for that. Texter writes in, "Upset that I vetoed Husson's Pizza." What's the love with Husson's Pizza here? Am I missing something on the love for Husson's Pizza? I don't get it. I'm not sure that I understand where all of this love for Husson's Pizza is coming from here. And first of all, I don't even think you can say that Husson's, it won't matter. It's not close by anymore. Yeah, you have to go up I-64 a little ways. So it's definitely outside of what we're considering best college town pizza. So that's the only one I'm vetoing. Doesn't qualify. Didn't reopen after a car went through it. And the next location is far enough away where if you're a Marshall student, you can't just hop in the car and head down and get some pizza real quick. Or you just really can't hop in a car and drive a few minutes away to get some. It's not close enough. It doesn't count. I disqualify it. But if you love it, that's fine. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. And of course, I have to mention, We did run a promotion, a contest, a few months ago, Munch Madness, and we had a pizza region, and Star Country Market and Pizza won the pizza region, and the pepperoni was voted best pizza in the tri-state. So I'm going to have to go try some of that now. It's in Rush, Kentucky. So for our purposes, it doesn't count unless you're driving to Rush, Kentucky. And so let me ask you this. How far are you driving? And I don't think you can count it because, again, it's in Rush. So that's a little bit past Colton, and it's a little bit past Cannonsburg. So I'm going to disqualify that. Even though it's our Munch Madness winner, I acknowledge it, but I'm going to have to disqualify that just from this exercise. But it sounds like we've got no clear winner here, but a lot of people were saying Everoni. So maybe we can get Everoni's to cater the show one day, huh? A lot of people were saying Giovanni, so maybe I can get Giovanni's to cater the show one day. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. That is our number to be a part of the program here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. Don't forget, coming up tonight, we have got baseball action back on the air with the Pirates taking on the Giants. 7:05, first pitch right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. And, of course, if you're looking for Kentucky basketball, that's coming up tomorrow. The Global Jam Basketball Tournament, it's in Toronto. And Kentucky decimated Canada 93-69 last night. Next up, Africa, tomorrow 1:30 on Cant Sports 93.3 and 1340. I saw some photos earlier. They went to Drake's $100 million mansion. Are you familiar with Drake? He's big in Canada. So Drake's got a basketball court inside of his mansion. And so UK was there today. And let me tell you, it's better than a lot of colleges. It's really nice. So look for it on Twitter if you can. That's where I found it. Now, of course, you know, if you're a wealthy, and I'm talking about very wealthy performer, you can afford a $100 million mansion with your own basketball court that's suitable for practice, suitable for the Kentucky Wildcats. Look at this and Google it if you can. It's nuts how cool it is. I'm gonna give an honest opinion here. It's now if you're gonna like sit here in here and just say spectate, it's not designed for that. But there's like a crow's nest in this thing, and you know, it's well stocked. The court itself has got enough room for the team, obviously, and the walls around it look like they're padded, and you know, going to obviously provide a little cushion there. So, you know, there's no going out of bounds here on the basketball court here, the way it's designed. But at the same time, this thing's better than most college practice facilities that I've seen. So you should check this thing out. It's really nice if you haven't seen it already. And so that's pretty cool that they're going to practice on that. And, of course, the crow's nest, the area where you can sit above and watch, it's pretty nice as well. I've seen some really good practice facilities as of late here. That's the next arms race, I think, in college basketball. After name, image, and likeness, it's definitely going to be, hey, how much more can you put into your practice facility? Make it like a really calm, cool place for your players to go shoot around. Because honestly, I know it's very hard sometimes to, if you're a school trying to fund an athletic department, to have those kind of amenities. But you know, it's really cool that you don't have to go into the arena anymore to practice the way that you're used to. And so if you need time on the court, you can work around the practice court schedule. And Marshall's done a really nice job in Gullickson getting that up to spec, actually having a nice space. But if I had $100 million to build a mansion, I'm building a basketball court the way Drake's got it. So UK practicing at Drake's place. A lot of people have never probably stepped on a court that nice. And so I was impressed with it today. I think that's going to do it for this edition. Don't forget, you can find me on Twitter at Paul Swann. Of course, the text line always open during the show, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Back on Monday, we've got a busy week. We're going to have a new track coach officially introduced on Tuesday. I'm looking forward to that. Also, I'm hoping that, just kind of give you an idea of what we're going to be doing next week. Jim Birmingham recently passed away, if you've been following along, former Huntington Blizzard player. And so there are going to be a lot of players from the Huntington Blizzard days that are coming into Huntington. And so I'm going to be there next weekend for that. But we're going to try to work it out with the schedules when these guys are coming in. Some of them, we're going to have a few of them on the program leading up to that. And so if you're a fan of hockey in Huntington from the day, you're a fan of the Huntington Blizzard, and you're a fan of Jim Birmingham, we're going to have some, I think, some really fun conversations to remember him, and that's coming up next week. Have a great weekend, everyone. I'll be back with you Monday. Until then, we'll talk to you soon.
WRBC Huntington, W227BS Huntington. This is your radio home for Pittsburgh Pirates baseball, ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.